Na, Kleine, du siehst aber gut heute Abend aus, ha? Wie wär's? Wir gehen nach mir nach Hause und ignorieren die sozioökologischen Probleme der deutschen Jugend zusammen, ha? Das würde dir gefallen, oder? Ja, 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 ja. Mach eine Raute mit deiner Hand und ich steck meinen Schwanz. Guten fucking Tag, you Kings and Queens. Well, can I say that anymore? I mean, in light of recent events and stuff. On a completely unrelated note, if you ever wanted to start a family tree full of cancer bastards, it seems like German heritage is the way to go. And to do that, you're gonna need to learn how to flirt in German. And yes, I have taped a microphone to my hairbrush. It makes me feel like I'm stage again. It makes me happy. Shut the fuck up. Now, you might think, flirting in German? That's impossible, and there'd be all the reason to believe that, because that language has the tonal grace of reading out an instruction manual. It's like a verbal artillery cannon. And today, we're going to use that cannon on the ladies. You could say we're literally going to howitzer. I've peaked, I'm never making another video again. I can't top that joke. God, when I wink, I just look like something seriously wrong with me. It probably is. And now, before any of you German fans come with that classic, "Ah, but German's a poetic language, have you ever read Kafka? Dude turns into a cockroach!" Bruder, du lebst in einer Lüge. Germany is a very proper place when it comes to flirting. Let's say that straight up. If you're from England and you're an English tourist, then first of all, stay the fuck out of our country. Second of all, you might be used to laying it on thick, walking up to a girl like, "Yo, what's up, you fit bird, innit? You looking for a lad? Yeah, innit, bruv." Don't do that, or in any other civilized country really, because it's just going to be perceived as a joke, which is exactly what you deserve for having no game. Germans appreciate an honest and entertaining conversations. We actually like being talked to. And yes, Germans sometimes can be a little shy to approach, but you shouldn't let that stop you. Most of us are very nice if you're entertaining and fun to talk to, and if you're not, get ready for one of the harshest rejections of your life. In Germany, we call it einen Korb kriegen, which basically means getting a basket, which is very, very accurate because we are going to take your heart and slam dunk it through a basket and the floor underneath with a force that makes you question of how we ever failed at Stalingrad. Now, if that scares you, don't worry. You can speak English to Germans. They won't mind. We actually love speaking English because it's an easygoing, easy language. You don't need to draw up a plan of attack like every sentence you want to speak in German. Honestly, it's no problem. Speaking English is like the easy mode for us. But if you still want to try doing it in German, then this is the video for you. God, you must love torturing yourself. Which, no worries, we have a lot of dungeon porn for you. Now, there's a lot of stereotypes going on about Germans, like this American lady right here, who made a little YouTube video telling us that all Germans are shy because no German guy approached her.
But in Germany, the thing is the guys, they don't talk to you, but most of the time, they're not gonna approach you, no matter how attractive or how cool they think you are. They all have great, big confidence lack in their personalities.
God, I hope she's seeing a doctor soon, because from all that reaching, her back reading must be in pain. To me, it's wild that you never considered the fact they might not approach you because you're a self-entitled, annoying American and not because Germans are shy. Literally, you're American, you have no cultural leg to stand on because they both have been shot. Alright, let's start at the very basics though. Let's start at the beginning. The first word you need to learn flirt in German is nein, which means no, which means go away, which means leave me alone, which means just take the L, which means no in every single language and culture in the world. That one's for the lads watching. Now let's dive into some actual romantic language in German. If my German voice makes you feel all tingly and nice inside, then go and see a psychiatrist, you fucking freak. See, I started researching this by watching some videos of people trying to pick up Germans on the street with the classical pickup lines, and I have to say,
so eine schöne Jacke, die passt zu meiner Bettwäsche.
Ja, schön, ne?
Zu deiner Bettwäsche, interessant.
Ja.
Ah.
Ich habe meine Handynummer verloren, kann ich deine haben? Warum denn nicht?
Ich hab gerade was im Mund.
Bruder, ich muss wirklich ganz dringend los. Don't do any of that. That is exactly what you do not want to do. Germans might be awkward, and trust me, they are. But once approached properly, it's just like having small talk with anyone else in the world. You don't need to be this cringe to get anywhere. Some classic German ways to approach someone might be like, "Alles gut bei dir? Oh, was bringt dich hierher? Oh, was hältst du vom Rechtsruck in der deutschen Politik, welcher nur losgetreten wurde, um ein paar reichen weißen Leuten mehr Macht zu verschaffen? Und besonders im Hinblick auf unsere Geschichte mit Faschismus halte ich jede Annäherung an diese Ideologie für komplett verwerflich." That last one works every time. Once you've started a conversation, just find some common ground to talk about. Germans love cities. We talk about our cities all the time, way too fucking much. So something good to say would be like, oh, was sind deine Lieblingsorte hier in Köln? Oh, kommst du aus München? Ich bin neu hier und will die Stadt erkunden, falls du irgendwelche Vorschläge hast. That's an easy way to kick off a conversation and not be cringe. Which is really what all of us Germans want. We have very little cringe resistance, which is why people like this American woman from earlier doesn't get approached at all. It's important to know that there's a big focus on approaching someone the right way in Germany, which is why we seem shy towards people from other countries sometimes. But we just don't like being fucking cringe. To be honest, it should be like that everywhere in the world. We're just way ahead of the curve. On the flip side though, that's the reason why a lot of German relationships are started with people introducing friends of friends, like psychopaths making their Barbie dolls kiss. Now that you open the gates of hell, that is general small talk, you can actually start sliding in some compliments. But oh no, cringe danger ahead. Be very careful or you could ruin your shot with someone German right here. If you say something like, du bist wunderschön, or you are gorgeous in English, the only thing you're gonna elicit is a bit of slime choking up their throat in disgust. Because as soon as you say anything like that, you sound like an old German grandma doting over her grandchildren, like, oh, guck dir an, wie süß er ist. Oh, er ist so erwachsen geworden. Hier sind 10 Euro, du hast keine Wahl, du nimmst sie jetzt an. Well, what other avenue are you supposed to take then? It's quite simple, really. Just give him a real, honest compliment. For example, if they are fun to talk to, you could tell them that. Or if they seem very knowledgeable about a certain topic, you could tell them that as well. Du bist ein guter Gesprächspartner. / Gesprächspartnerin. You are very fun to talk to. Du scheinst darüber sehr informiert zu sein. You are very informed about this topic. Now, once you've established each other as people you can actually fucking stand, which to be fair is quite a rarity, and they haven't said anything like, I'm not a Nazi, but, oh well, I don't really mind those refugees, but I do have to say, then you're good to go to take the safety lock off and unleash some of the real cringe. Very basic one. Kann ich dir einen Drink anbieten? Can I get you a drink? Hast du Pläne für den Rest des Abends? Are you doing anything after this? Wenn ich das so anmerken darf, du hast wunderschöne X. If I may say so, you have beautiful, insert any part of their genetic makeup here. Like for example, wenn ich das so anmerken darf, du hast die perfekte Körperform, um uns einen Sieg an der Ostfront zu garantieren. And that's just some examples through my lens of speaking very proper posh German. Some people will probably drop down in the comments some more skeevier phrases you can use. In any case, if you find yourself a nice German boo, here's some pet names you could use. The most important one is probably Freund oder Freundin, which means boyfriend or girlfriend. But it's important to note it can also just mean a friend. And if that's confusing to you, you have to understand that we Germans believe in getting out of the friend zone. Because if anything, establishing peaceful territory and then invading it anyways is the most German thing anyone could do. Schatz! This one's quite high on the cringe scale, but it's fine. It's literally what the German version of Gollum says, so that should give you a good idea of how slightly cringy it is. Lieber or Liebe, my lovely, and it can be romantic. When addressing your partner, it can also just mean something like my lovely brother, as in my lovely brother sneaked into my room at midnight and smoked away my entire stash. Where the fuck is that Hurensohn? We got a lot of English ones as well. We got stuff like babe or bae, but they're little cringe, so only use them if you got cringe points to spare. Now for a bit of a derogatory one, we got Alte / Olle, which refers to someone's girlfriend, and it means something like, oh, you old hag, or the old wife. Unfortunately, there's nothing like it for the male equivalent, because equality, I guess. But don't use those, they're fucking whack. You merely sound like a 40-year-old bald German dude drinking the shittest fucking ales in the pub. We also have pickup lines, but using any of these unironically will probably result in the immediate evacuation from you as a person. You will use any of these on any German and they will immediately go, God, it's schon so spät. Oh, Bruder, ich muss wirklich jetzt ehrlich ganz, ganz, ganz dringend los. One of my favorites I recently learned from some Cologne-based friends is this one. Girl, du bist Tzatziki und ich bin Kebab. Zusammen sind wir eine türkische Pizza.
Don't ever use that.
Hey, ich habe meine Telefonnummer verloren. Könnte ich mir vielleicht deine leihen? Oh, Entschuldigung. Glaubst du an Liebe auf den ersten Blick oder soll ich nochmal reinkommen? And then we got the worst one. Oh, this is a big red flag. Hat es wehgetan, als du vom Himmel gefallen bist? You get it, because they're an angel? Oh, how creative. There's a perfect response for this one, though. Nicht so sehr, wie als du deinen Mund aufgemacht hast. Girl, are you a concentration camp? Because I want to shoot some kids inside you. Don't use that one. Oh well, that's basically all I have to say on the topic of German flirting. I hope this was in any way helpful through the layers of sarcasm that us Germans tend to project. If it was, I hope you enjoyed this video. If it wasn't and you don't think the German style of flirting is suited to you, then you should try being less of a fucking creep. Now that you're all ready, it's time to get in shape, style your hair, get dressed, and cry about your ex for 3 hours. Thanks all of you for watching. I don't really have anything else to say. I really appreciate the continuing support from German people and people trying to learn German watching my videos. I probably would have never made a second one without you guys. There's definitely not a third one, and I am going to make more. So stay tuned, subscribe, check out some of my other content. I've got loads of comedy sketches I've been doing, which I think, if you like my sense of humor, you will enjoy. That's all I have to say. Goodbye. Mein Life bunt wie ein Atelier. Gründe Vorzug, mach spät. Gehen drauf, ist Color Grading. Ich bin high, wie ein Alien. Teile Welten, der Scheiß gefällt mir. Ich glaub, ich bleib länger da. Ein Bein, zwei Chips, kennst du ja. Bin auf Loop seit letzter Nacht und ich rock, als wär's nothing. Ihr Booty fluffy wie Matratzen. Aber sie will auf mir Platz nehmen. Baby, ist cute, so wie ein Cupcake.